Alright guys, next we are going to see how we can pass parameters using the TestNG XML file. In the earlier we have already seen about the data provider. So this is another way to pass parameters into our test cases. Now this is a sample TestNG XML that I have created, and if you can see over here, I have a suite 1 and it has parallel equal to method. So let me remove this for the moment. Because this is not of our concern right now. So what we have in this suite is a suite level parameter called suite param, and it has a value called this is at suite level, and then we have a test called suite 1 and then test called suite 2, and third we have a test called suite 3. So this is just a naming convention that I have used. You can also use, let me rename the test as test1, test2, test3, so that it does not confuse you. Test1, then we have test2, and then we have test3. So these three tests are there in our class, test class. Now these three tests, let's look into all the three tests one by one. This first test has a classes tag in which I have class name as the testng.demo.source.firsttest, and this is our main class. First test is our only class that we are considering right now, in which we have a method stack, and this method stack has an include tag. This include tag states that we will be including only this particular method called registration in our test 1. So that's what this test 1 is doing. It is executing the registration tag, registration method. Then we have test 2, which has this login method getting executed, and then we have test 3, which has this reservation method getting executed. All are included in our first test class. So now for providing parameters to our test, we have something called as parameter tag. So here we have a suite level parameter which is right after the suite tag, and it is called suite-param. It has a value called this is at suite level. Then we have something called parameter test param. This particular test param is under the test tag, and that's why it has a value called this is at test level. So the third test has two parameters. First one is overridden parameter. Suite parameter, we already saw it was declared under the suite tag. Now we have overridden this inside the test. So this is overridden suite param, and that's why I have mentioned this its value as this is overridden suite level parameter. And I have another parameter called test param 1, and I have put the value as this is a local test level parameter, and I have included the method reservation. So let's have a look at the first test class. First test class has our three methods and a fourth method, that is the checkout method, which is not of importance right now. It won't get executed. So let's start looking into the methods one by one. So for registration, we are passing suite param as a parameter with the parameter stack @parameter stack, and it has this suite param. This suite param value should exactly match our parameter value over here, parameter name value over here. So since this is suite-param, this is also suite-param. So for the first registration, we are passing it at suite level. For the login test, we are passing it at test level, and for reservation test, we are passing the test param at test level, and we are overriding this suite param. So that's what we are doing. Let's go ahead, save our TestNG XML since we did some changes, and now we will execute the TestNG XML. Remember, the output is very important in this scenario. So once we get the output, I will put it in a Notepad++ and explain you in detail. Started execution and it has executed. So this is our testng execution status, and we will go into the console. We will copy everything from here. Copy it and then go to Notepad++. So this is from a previous test. And here we go. So we have this testng XML getting executed. First is the registration one got executed, and this is at suite level. Why we got this is at suite level? Because for registration one method, we had included the suite level parameter, which was declared under the suite tag, and that's why this is at suite level. Then we have the login method that is getting executed, and it has a test level parameter, and the value for the test level parameter is at test level. And then comes the most important part, suite level parameter and test level parameter. But this suite level parameter is a overridden suite level parameter, and the test level parameter is a local test level parameter. So let's have a look at the output. Reservation suite param, this is a overridden suite level parameter, and reservation test param, this is a local test level parameter. So we got all the output as expected. Since we had overridden the suite level parameter in our test 3, we got the appropriate output. And since we had put a local test param 1 in our test 3, we got the same output, as this is a local test level parameter. So this is what we get. So in short, if we put something under suite level, it will apply to the entire suite. And if we put something under test level, it will apply to only that particular test. If we override something which is declared at the suite level inside the test level, then the overridden parameter will take effect. So this is a summary of parameter passing using testng XML. Thank you.